In his latest round of SpaceX-related tweets, CEO Elon Musk says that the company has plans to boost Raptor's performance by at least 15%, and the number of those engines installed on Starship by 50%. In this video, we are going to look. SpaceX is considering adding 3 more vacuum-optimized engines to Starship's 6 planned Raptors, leaving ships with 6 Raptor vacuum engines and 3 sea-level optimized engines, and the same variant on Super Heavy. Those updated goals came hand-in-hand with significant changes to the design and operation of both Starship and its Super Heavy booster, which at one point was expected to utilize a boost variant of Raptor that would trade thrust vector control that is gimballing and a wide throttle range for far greater thrust. At least according to Musk's latest account, that substantially different Raptor Boost variant is now no more. On July 3rd, NASASpaceflight forum member and photographer BocaChicaGal captured photos of SpaceX delivering 3 new Raptor engines to its Boca Chica Starship factory. 2 of those engines, RB3 and RB4, featured Raptor Boost labels, and were likely the first engines of their kind to complete qualification testing in McGregor, Texas. As of their arrival in South Texas, it was assumed that Raptor Boost still represented a variant of the engine, with almost 50% more thrust at the cost of gimbal and throttle authority. However, Musk himself replied to some of the resulting tweets later that evening, revealing that Super Heavy's outer ring of up to 20 Raptor Boost engines would indeed have no ability to gimbal but would still be able to throttle. Later the same day, the SpaceX CEO clarified further, stating that the company now plans to upgrade Raptor's existing design to boost engine thrust to approximately 230 tons, approximately 510,000 lbf, while still maintaining a wide throttle range and optional thrust vector control. With such an engine, all Raptors on a Super Heavy booster, whether fixed or gimballing, would be the same. The only unique aspect of Raptor Boost, then, would be their installation around the inner ring of Super Heavy's skirt and their resulting lack of gimbal authority. It's somewhat unclear, then, why 2 of the engines SpaceX delivered on July 3rd were labeled RB-, and one explicitly outfitted with a name tag reading, "Hello, my name is Boost." Notably, a quick side-by-side comparison, enabled by those photos, strongly implies that Raptor Booster Engine 3 RB3 and Raptor 79 R79 are virtually identical aside from RB3's rerouted plumbing and unique mounting hardpoints. In other words, barring surprises, the Boost nomenclature appears to be more vestigial than anything. Ultimately, as Musk notes, if SpaceX manages to boost Raptor 2 to 230 tons of thrust, a Super Heavy booster with 33 mostly identical engines would have a peak liftoff thrust around 7,600 tons, approximately 16.8 million lbf, translating to a thrust-to-weight ratio of more than 1.5. For a large rocket with liquid propulsion only, a thrust-to-weight ratio greater than 1.5 is very respectable and improves acceleration off the launch pad, reduces gravity losses in the first few minutes of ascent, and thus boosts overall efficiency. Already, Musk's implication that 33 engines could ultimately be installed on Super Heavy is a departure from comments the CEO made barely a month ago, when he revealed a base increase from 28 to 29 engines, with the possibility of expanding to 32 down the road. Also new is the implication that SpaceX is considering adding 3 more vacuum-optimized engines to Starship's 6 planned Raptors, leaving ships with 6 Raptor vacuum RVAC engines and 3 sea-level optimized engines, the same variant on Super Heavy. Musk says that SpaceX has yet to decide if Raptor vacuum will be commonized with Raptor 2, boosting its thrust, or if greater efficiency will be pursued instead. Regardless, even with 6 200-ton thrust RVACs and 3 Raptor 2s, Starship would produce upwards of 2,000 tons of thrust in vacuum, creating an upper stage with almost as much thrust as Falcon Heavy, and a fully fueled thrust-to-weight ratio of approximately 1.7, even better than Super Heavy. Rephrased, in its current design, Starship will never be able to reach orbit without Raptor engines capable of continuously operating for around 6 minutes. Up until high-altitude Starship test flights began in December 2020, the extent of Raptor's long-duration capabilities and thus the state of SpaceX testing was effectively a mystery. McGregor typically completes multiple static fires every day, and already performed similar duration testing of Merlin vacuum engines, and upper stages, so it's possible, if not probable, that one or several other 5 or 6 minute long tests, have simply been missed over the last few months. With at least the first test flight of Super Heavy and Starship set to splashdown, as opposed to a return to a landing site, a large stock of Raptor engines will be required, before the engines are expected to return, with their vehicles for future flights. Super Heavy will now host 29 engines on its aft, as observed via a photo of a new thrust puck of Super Heavy, and then confirmed by Musk on Twitter. He added that Super Heavy would eventually evolve to hosting 32 engines. The supply line for this engine demand is being focused at the production site at SpaceX HQ in Hawthorne, California. Musk added that Raptor production is approaching one every 48 hours, most likely a reference to one Raptor rolling off the production line every 48 hours. Raptors are then shipped to SpaceX's test center at McGregor in Texas, where they are test-fired to validate the engines ahead of being sent to the South Texas launch site. SpaceX currently utilizes two horizontal test bays and one vertical tripod test stand, the latter converted from being a Falcon 9 test stand. During his latest fly past, photos from NSF's Gary Blair in the L2 McGregor section spotted Raptors in all three bays, including what appears to be another new Raptorback engine. While no sea-level Raptors were seen on the test stands during Saturday's pass, SpaceX has shown rapid pace with sea-level Raptor production in the past, which will be required for upcoming Super Heavy test flights. McGregor has already supplied engines up to SN-74, with that engine seen arriving into Starbase along with SN-72 last week. The Raptor van is making almost daily trips on the Texas highways between the two sites, meaning the stock of Raptors already at Starbase could be in double digits. Near the Raptor test stands is a facility that SpaceX is currently using to test Starship and Super Heavy RCS thrusters. On his weekly flight, Gary Blair spotted the potential test stand for these hot gas thrusters, used to steer the ship and booster to their destinations. As Elon Musk mentioned on Twitter, SpaceX currently aims to have the hot gas thrusters ready for the first orbital test flight. While most of S-20's upgrades are a mystery, the ship's thrust dome, spotted in work at Boca Chica earlier this month, has already confirmed that the prototype will be the first, with the necessary hardware for Raptor vacuum engine installation. That likely means that S-20 will also be the first Starship to attempt to static fire 6 Raptor engines, potentially producing more thrust than a Falcon 9 booster. On June 27, one such vacuum-optimized Raptor RVAC arrived in Boca Chica for the first time ever, making it clear that the comparatively brand new engine may already be ready to start integrated Starship testing. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.